we are wrapping up a series that we have called Catch the Wind. And we have talked throughout this series a lot about wind and a lot about windmills. And we even spent some time last week, if you were here with us or caught us online, out at the Drummond Ranch Wind Farm. And I don't know if you've ever been up close to those windmills. That was my first time. I had a chance to go and be a part of that video. And that was my first time being that close to those windmills. And those things are impressive. When you get close to them, you know, from a distance, they're pretty impressive. But you get close, man, they are impressive structures. My only experience really with windmills was the windmill that was in my grandparents' front yard in Kansas. It was only about 6 or 7 feet, and it just sat as a decoration in my grandparents' front yard. You could see it from the picture window as you looked out into the yard, and it was a sturdy, well-built structure. I know that firsthand because there were many times when I was playing wiffle ball with my brothers in the front yard where I would run into the windmill and it did not move. I moved, right? And so I would get up, and this happened multiple times. I don't know at what point I realized it was there because it never moved, but I would go inside crying because I was hurt, and my grandma would give me a paper towel with water on it because that fixed everything, right? And my grandpa would look at me and just say, like, you're a dummy. What are you doing? Like, why do you keep running into the windmill? But it was just a well-built, sturdy structure that sat in their yard. It really served no purpose. It was a mere decoration in the yard of my grandparents in the small town of Grantville, Kansas. Chad said this last week. He said, but just as a windmill without wind serves no purpose, the same is true for a church that isn't empowered by God's Spirit. A church that isn't propelled by the Holy Spirit is nothing more than a nice social club, nothing more than a mere decoration on the landscape of our culture, and that's not what Jesus intended his church to be. Over the past few weeks, we've been walking through the book of Acts, and God's Spirit shows up into the early church, and it explodes on the scene, and the church explodes on the scene because they caught the wind of the Holy Spirit. In the first few chapters of the book of Acts, we see as God's Spirit comes down on the early church, the church is born for the very first time. A few chapters later, we see the Spirit of God come onto Peter, and Peter takes the gospel to the Gentiles for the very first time. We continue on in the book of Acts and we see God's Spirit begin to lead the Apostle Paul. And God's Spirit leads him and changes the direction and the course that Paul wanted to take, the direction Paul was going. And I love what Paul did in that moment. He didn't fight the direction of the Spirit. He didn't fight where the Spirit called him to. He merely followed the leading of God's Spirit. And we see the church in Philippi is born.